to Spotlight's bullish tech picks. Melissa Armo is with us, founder, owner of the stock Swoosh, to talk about the recent rally we've been seeing. Melissa Armo, great to see you. I haven't seen you in a while. Wanted to talk about the tech rally. Obviously, we've seen the NASDAQ up over 30% and a lot of names that have been driving this market, period. Where do you think we're headed and why?
Well, I think it's really interesting because we're going into a short week for the market next week, but then after that, the week after that, earnings season starts. So while, you know, everyone's optimistic, yes, the market's been bullish, yes, we're up for the year, yes, we've rallied 6 months, the backdrop of the market is too many uncertainties in my mind that will continue this rally. So I'm not as optimistic for the second half of 2023 as most people are, because we still could have a recession in the fall towards the end of the year. And again, some people are already still saying that. And again, we already know that the Fed is going to increase rates at least a half a point between now and the end of the year. And what if they decide to raise rates more? This is more of a relief rally because they stayed the rate hike this month. But I would say it's really going to be driven by what happens in the summer months, July and August, the rest of the summer. What happens with earnings season? If you have companies come out and you have companies say, we're expecting less productivity, like they don't meet their revenue guidelines, then you're going to see some selling to the market and some stocks that have been rallying that are not going to continue.
Not likely to give it all back, though. So if you have a recession or a slowdown or earnings estimates come down some, do you think that there's a chance that we give this all back with the NASDAQ up 30%, the S&P up 15% this year? Do you see that or not likely?
Well, in order for that to happen, it could happen. I'm not saying 100%, but I'm saying, yes, it could happen. What would create something like us giving up all the gains for the year? That would have to be a catalyst or what I call an event. What would be an event? Something that we saw that almost happened last weekend with the conflict in Russia and Ukraine escalating. And if NATO gets involved, if we actually really get involved or something happens between China and Taiwan, yes, then that would rock markets. That could possibly take away all of the gains that the S&P and the QQQs have had for the entire year of 2023. Again, I'm not saying that happens in the next 6 months, but I'm saying that people need to know that it could. So if you're up, there's nothing wrong with taking profits. Book some of the profits that you've had so far this year, because we have had a run-up.
Right. We got our latest PCE inflation report, so things are looking, you know, we're seeing inflation coming down. We're watching that. In the meantime, let's talk, and we're going to have a panel on that later. NVIDIA and Apple, two clear winners of 2023. In fact, Apple at a new high today. Tell me a little bit about those names. You think they still have some room?
Definitely, if the market continues higher, and if Apple has good earnings, same thing with NVIDIA, they will run up. Again, their earnings, both of their earnings are out for a couple of weeks. But I expected Apple to be over 180 and really 190 long before this week. So, yes, I'm happy that it finally rallied and made brand new all-time highs, which it did today. In a normal bullish market, the good old days that we're used to, Apple already would have been at 200, Nicole. So, yes, you can cheer up and down. Apple is bullish. That is one of my top watches, NVIDIA too. Again, that sector is strong. The problem is you're not seeing an overall broad-based rally in multiple sectors enough. One of the problematic sectors is the banks. And again, they launch earnings season on July 14th. So, and Apple and NVIDIA don't report until after the banks report. So you're not going to have the market continuing higher and make brand new all-time highs without the financials. They've got to get going. But yes, I do like Apple. Yes, I do like NVIDIA. And those are one of the things, if you want to hold those things, you could.
And then we turn our attention over to Baidu, which says China to me, Wells Fargo, which says banks. But these are sort of individual stories, too, because the banks just passed all the stress tests and everything. But your thoughts on what's going on with these two names?
Well, I think it's great the banks passed the stress test, but you got to look at it. They were prepared for it more so than any. If they had done the stress test before all of the havoc that happened earlier in the year, then maybe they wouldn't have had the same outcome. So banks have been beefing up. You've seen all kinds of offers out there, you know, three-month CD rates and all of these bonus offers. Open up an account, get $1,000. So you're seeing banks compete more for high for deposits, for high interest rates. They want customers so that they can pay them 4.5%, 5%. So banks beefed up their assets assets by doing these offers, and then they did pass the stress test. But it does not mean, Nicole, that we're not going to see another regional bank fail between now and the end of the year. And of course, Baidu goes with China. They had some negative data that came out, and that fell. And I do think Baidu could possibly be lower even into next week, into the holiday week.
Right. That's another point, a holiday week as well. Melissa Armo, nice to see you. Thank you so much for being on today. The Stock Swoosh, appreciate it. Thank you, Melissa.